I'm Any New Province, and this week we're playing Burn for Net Benefits, the series where we explore the benefits of net decking in Pauper. PDW1 took this spicy list to a top 8 finish in the Pauper Challenge this weekend. The reason it's so spicy is because it's running the new downshift Get to You Lava Runner. This burn deck differs wildly from other burn decks in its creature base, starting with Get to You Lava Runner, which is a red mana for a 1-1, and if there are two or more instant and or sorcery cards in your graveyard, Get to You Lava Runner gets +1, +0, and has haste. There's always a debate as to whether you should be running creatures in your burn deck at all. A lot of people will say you're just turning on your opponent's removal. The great thing about Lava Runner is that it can come down and start hitting for two as early as turn one with Gitaxian Probe. That means by the time your opponent does draw a removal spell to kill Lava Runner, it's already put in a ton of work. Our only other creature is similar to Lava Runner in the sense that it gets some work done even if your opponent has a removal spell for it. It's Keldon Marauders. It costs 1 and a red for a 3-3, and when it enters the battlefield or leaves the battlefield, it deals 1 damage to your opponent. We'd love to crack in with this 3-3 a bunch of times, but unfortunately it has Vanishing too, which means this creature enters the battlefield with 2 time counters on it. At the beginning of your upkeep, remove a time counter from it. When the last is removed, sacrifice it. This is a burn deck, so of course the rest of the deck is filled with burn spells. I'll start with our 1 mana burn. We have Lava Spike, which costs 1 red and it deals 3 damage to target creature or planeswalker, and we have Lightning Bolt, which costs 1 red and it deals 3 damage to any target, differing from Lava Spike and that can also hit creatures. Chain Lightning is very similar to our other 1 mana burn spells. It's a sorcery like Lava Spike, so it dodges Dispel, and it can hit any target like Lightning Bolt, so it doubles as a removal. Unfortunately, after we hit a player or permanent with this, that player or that permanent's controller may pay red-red. If that player does, they may copy this spell and may choose new targets for that copy. Fortunately enough, we're a burn deck, so if they send a copy of this back at us, we'll just send another copy straight back at them. Our last 1 mana burn spell is Rift Bolt. It deals 3 damage to any target. I'm saying that it's a 1 mana burn spell even though it costs 2 and a red because we usually cast it for its suspend cost, which means rather than cast this card from your hand, you may pay red and exile it with a time counter on it. At the beginning of your upkeep, remove a time counter. When the last is removed, cast it without paying its mana cost, so it really does just cost 1 mana on your first turn, and then on turn 2, you send it at your opponent's face for free. Next, I'm going to talk about some of the spells in our deck that have utility beyond just being burn spells. First, we have Incinerate. It costs 1 and a red, it's an instant, and it deals 3 damage to any target. Fortunately, any creature that's hit with Incinerate can't be regenerated this turn. That's to hit all of those river boas or something like a young wolf. We're running 2 Magma Jets to help us filter our draws a little bit. It costs 1 and a red, it deals 2 damage to any target, and if it resolves, we get to scry 2. While most of our burn spells can double as removal, this last utility burn spell always wants to be removal. It's Searing Blaze, it costs red-red, and it says, Searing Blaze deals 1 damage to target player or planeswalker, and 1 damage to target creature that player or planeswalker's controller controls. Dealing 1 to something can usually be useful, but we usually want to trigger the landfall ability on Searing Blaze. If you had a land enter the battlefield under your control this turn, Searing Blaze deals 3 damage to that player or planeswalker, and 3 damage to that creature instead. Our last utility spell is one of the only other spells in our deck that isn't a burn spell. It's Gitaxian Probe. It costs 1 blue Phyrexian mana. We'll never pay blue for it, so we'll always pay the 2 life. It says, look at target player's hand, draw a card. This is an awesome cantrip just to smooth out our draws and cheat on lands a little bit more, but it also enables Get to Lava Runner as early as turn 1. I've saved our big burn spells for last. Our opponents may think they can survive at 4 life when they pass the turn back to us, but these spells are going to make sure that the game ends in a hurry. First, we have Fire Blast, which costs 4 red-red, but we're almost never going to pay that cost. It's an instant, and you may sacrifice 2 mountains rather than pay this spell's mana cost. Fire Blast deals 4 damage to any target. Our last non-land spell is Flame Rift. It costs 1 and a red for a sorcery that deals 4 damage to each player. It would be great if we could just send 4 mana at our opponent's face for 1 and a red, but we have to take the damage too. That means we have to hopefully have our opponent at such a low life total that we can afford taking another 4 damage to end the game. The mana base is just 17 basic mountains. That's probably the lowest number of lands I've ever played in a deck, but that's okay. We can filter to the ones we need with Magma Jet or cantrip into them with Gitaxian Probe. Alright, let's have a look at this sideboard. First, we have Blazing Volley. If our opponent's on all X1s and we've got to sweep the board, we have 1 Forgotten Cave if we're going to slow down a little bit and not be able to cantrip off of all of our Gitaxian Probes. We have Stagger Shocks for when we have to sneak through burn damage around counterspells. Our opponent can't counter 2 Stagger Shocks. We have 4 Seal of Fires for killing those tribes if there's a lot of those running around, and we have 4 Smash to Smithereens for blowing up all of Affinity's lands. And there it is, Burn by PDX1. Congratulations on your finish, PDX, and thank you so much for the advice that you gave me today over the Discord. We're going to take this deck live into a league at twitch.tv/anynewprovince. We're there every Monday night at 7 p.m. Atlantic time playing competitive Pauper decks. Before I go, I just want to let you know that you can like the video or subscribe to the channel down below. I'd seriously appreciate it. It's a great way to let me know you've enjoyed everything, and it really encourages me to keep making great Pauper content. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this deck tech, and hopefully I'll see you on Monday night.